you want me to talk about the Crouch slaves. I don't know a great deal about them. I only know what Uncle Will, who was born at the end of the Civil War, told me. But according to him, their family had families of slaves, and Jimmy Crouch and Carol and I used to play in the old slave quarters that were falling down when I was a little girl, 65 years ago. So I know the cabins were still there. One of the pieces of the family lore is that the black mammy who was in the house was a very strong and capable and smart woman. And the two sets of Civil War soldiers, North and the South both, would march through there and steal everything they could get their hands on. So this was a fairly well-off family. So she was worried that they would be destitute when the war was over. And so she lowered one of her sons into the biggest cistern on the place and had him dig out some bricks. And then she sent all the family silver and almost all the family money down in there. And a cistern is shaped sort of like a large jug. It has a narrow mouth and then it rolls out like this. So she had him go here where looking down in the cistern, they wouldn't see it, and hide all the valuables of silver and jewelry and money from the family. And then she saved much of the rest of the stuff of the family because they were very privileged slaves and they had underpinning in their cabins, which was very rare. So she had them build boxes under the slave quarters and put trap doors in over which they put rag rugs. And she put the best pillows and blankets and clothes that belonged to the family in those boxes under the slave quarters, and the soldiers would never have thought to look under slave quarters for anything of value. She saved the best of the livestock by teaching the young kids to put them on a rope, and there was a large forest-like thicket in the back of the place, and she would have them lead the pigs, the cows, and the best horses to a pen that they had built back in this thicket, but they were never to take the same path twice, so there was no beaten livestock path. And she left enough that they could see so that they wouldn't think there was a large group of horses or cows or pigs or anything hidden out. And so that's how she saved the livestock for the family. And my understanding is that she stayed with the family and helped the mother of the six Crouch children for many years because the father had died early. The only direct thing that my mother remembered is she remembers early one Sunday morning when she was a girl, an old rattletrap buggy and a horse driven by an old black man came riding up the lane that led to the Crouch home place. And this man got out and he said, "Master Will, you remember me, I'm Willie." And Uncle Will said, "Of course I remember you, Willie." He said, "Master Will, I'm in really big trouble. I need to borrow $10. And I knew you would help me because if you don't," and I don't remember what the dire circumstances were if he didn't have the $10, but he told Uncle Will that he would pay him 50 cents back every other Sunday until he had the debt paid. And Mother remembered him coming in his rattletrap old buggy and his poor old horse all the way from La Center to Uncle Will's house and bringing him 50 cents every other Sunday, which would have been 20 Sundays, which would have been 40, which would have been the better part of a year to pay back that $10 debt. But he paid back every penny, and Uncle Will did not charge him any interest.